late. Amen. Thank you, Bona woman of today. Hallelujah. We want to thank God for today. We want to thank God for this time. I'm not going to take a long time. I'm going to talk briefly about offering. Amen. About giving, actually.
Hello.
I know it's a topic that everyone knows. There's nothing new that I'm going to talk about. But I believe God has given me something to share just briefly. There's so many teachings, so many sayings, so many fundamentals that has been spoken about giving. But can you just turn our book, Luke chapter 6, verse 37. Luke chapter 6, verse 37. And I will read when everyone has got there. So from verse 37, judge not, and you will not be judged. Condemn not, and you will not be condemned. Forgive, and you will be forgiven. If you forgive, you will be forgiven. Amen.
Amen.
You forgive. There's a gift there if you can read. Amen. If you forgive, you'll be forgiven. Amen. You give and you'll be forgiven. You give and then something returns to you. Then 38 says, give and it will be given to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over. Can you all read from 38, whichever version you have? From verse 38, let's go together. Give and it will be given to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, will be put into your lap. For with the measure you use, it will be measured back to you. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah, victorious babies. This is an exciting verse. It's a promise on its own. Amen. A promise as it is. It just explains itself. If you give, it will be given back to you. With a multiplication, just like a seed, you plant one seed of a corn, and you get how many seeds from there? I don't know how many cob a seed will bring. Amen. Just as simple as that. Just like as you give and you'll be running over. This is the result of what you've done. For example, there's this thing here, a little, like a bottle. Amen.
Amen.
If it's full already, and you pour into this bottle, you're giving into this bottle, right? When God gives you back, when it's full like this, He'll give you more. He will pour more. Amen.
Amen.
And what does it do when you pour more? When
God
overflows, what happens?
Wow.
Now we are in a class, amen. When this, when God is now pouring back to you, amen.
Amen.
It runs where?
Oh.
Okay, maybe we just shake it. Maybe I've seen people who put you in the car, and they used to wonder what's happening with them. They shake the car. I have been seeing this. What is this? They say there's some air bubbles to create more space. So that is full. So this Bible is saying, shaken together,
yes,
to create more space, right?
Yes. Yes.
Drink the water.
Wow.
Amen. What happened?
gives.
Hallelujah. There's so many things that you can give, your time and everything. I'm going to talk about the money maybe. Amen. You give it to the church, you can give it. The principle of giving, it just remains the same. God has done it.
Yes.
I mean, those that do not come to church, if they give, it will just come back to
you. Hallelujah.
Amen. When you want more of what you give to God,
God,
the blessing that comes with that, maybe for example, I send money to Zimbabwe, I've got my child is very sick and all that. Maybe I send the money to Zimbabwe and I think, oh man, I just come back, I have got 100 pounds, I need to pay my bread and bank bills. Oh, I'm going to send 20 pounds to Zimbabwe. Right? You send that 20 pounds to Zimbabwe. That same thing, you have saved it. Someone was it. There are some people that are struggling, they don't have a meal. Amen. Maybe the child is sick, they can't find even the fees for the hospital, now they're being charged. Amen.
Amen.
Maybe that child was sick and then the man should buy the medication. If it wasn't you, probably you have saved a life. Amen.
Amen.
Now what happens to this child? Amen. Maybe this child grows up and becomes a minister of God.
Amen.
That 20 pounds seed, that 20 pounds, if they have given 100 pounds, I don't know what will happen.
Mm-hmm.
So that evangelist is going to do what? It's going to preach the gospel.
Yes.
What is God's heart? God's heart is beating for the souls. Beating for the souls. So that plant you pray, they have forgotten it.
Yes.
But you know what? These people, when they are saved, they are praising God.
Amen.
Maybe in Japan, they are praising God.
Amen.
As a result of that 20 pounds. Amen.
Amen.
Now, all those people that are saved, they are just praying God, may you bless whoever that has made me know you. You have planted to someone's salvation. Amen.
Amen.
You have planted to someone's life.
Amen.
When they pray for you. Even God himself, he blesses, he has promised. His blessings comes in so many ways.
Amen.
It might not come as money, because money is not everything.
Yes.
We want money. I love money myself. But, but when you have got peace,
oh my God,
God gives you peace. In this difficult world, probably there's difficulties to protect you in situations that you might not be able to even understand what's happening. You find God's protecting your children, your family, your mom and dad is being at home. Maybe they are here. God is covering you, but you might not understand.
Amen.
You understand maybe one day when God explains and show you what you have done with whatever. It might be your physical state. You are helping someone.
Mm.
Just giving yourself, giving your physical. You seeing someone in the road struggling, maybe an elderly. You help them in any way. You help them with your time. Maybe you visit the sick man. I think that thing is gone. I don't know where it's gone. Maybe we left it in Africa or somewhere. Just visiting the school, they said, oh, now why are you visiting me? That's the problem. But probably you might give yourself time in prayer to pray for the people that have not known God. You are just giving. It's not only money. You give your time, you pray. Just say, I'm just praying for people in Pakistan. You don't know anyone. Just today, I'm praying for people in Pakistan.
Right.
And today, I just want to give in the house of God. When man is given in the house of God, God is going to use that money in the way that he wants at that time.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever that happens, it's that flowing that is running over.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like continuing, but now the time is
already.
Amen. So when we give, we should just know that we are not throwing our money.
Mm-hmm.
We are not wasting our money.
Mm-hmm.
What? Someone said, any work that you do for God is not going in vain. It's kind of a debt. God is going to repay you. That's what this verse is saying. With a measure, it shall be measured back to you. Multiplied times. Amen. So just as we prepare, as we give to the Lord, I don't know if you that simple song. Amen. I like that song. God keeps on doing that. Amen. Jehovah Jireh, the Lord my provider, he keeps on doing great things.
Jesus, that you give.